I'm Ryan Pearcy from Kuhn, North America. Today I want to talk about some of the features and benefits for our newest series of trail disc mowers, GMD TLs. The GMD TLs come in three different cutting widths: the 3150 at 10 foot 2 inches, the 3550 at 11 foot 6 inches, and then the 4050 like we see here, which is 13 foot of cut. Trail disc mowers are becoming more and more popular, as operators understand the benefits of having more and more weight on the rear wheels, instead of like traditional mounted machines where you have the weight on the back of the tractor, which takes more horsepower and more ballast to offset it. With this machine, we can cut up to 13 foot with as little as 60 PTO horsepower. We're going to start talking about the machine up front at the hitch. All trail, both disc mowers and mower conditioners we make, comes with our patented swivel hitch. The gyrodyne allows turning both to the right and to the left up to 90 degrees either way, so we can get nice tight corners from our fields. On the GMD TLs, we have two different styles of hitch. Either the traditional two-point, which is quick hitch compatible to be able to hook up quickly, or as we're going to see, the drawbar swivel hitch too. As we have seen, the drawbar swivel hitch 2 has been our most popular style of hitch. And being able to quickly hook up and unhook from the tractor, it's pretty easy to see why. To unhook from the tractor, simply have the jack in the lower position as I have now. And then what you're going to do is come up here. There's a retaining pin that you take out. The handle here, you take all the way up. Now, as I start to raise the jack, you're going to see two sections to this hitch. There is the side that is connected to the mower itself. It has a half clasp type of shape. Then on the cast side, the cast that is bolted through with this bolt right here to the drawbar, there is a big pin that clasp sits over. It's what it actually holds on to the connection point in between that and the tractor. As we pick it up, what you're looking for before you can unhook the machine completely is that the end of the clasp is higher than the retaining pin through here. At that point, simply take off your hydraulic hoses, your PTO, any of the other auxiliaries. Get in the tractor, pull forward, and you're disconnected. You can take this off by removing this pin, taking the bolt out. You can unhook that from your drawbar and use it for other uses. To hook back up is just as simple. Simply put the cast piece back on, back up, and get close to the retaining clasp at this point. You don't have to get exactly perfect, and I'll show you why. As you start to lower this down, if you're not exactly flush with the cast piece, you'll see that this can actually rotate. This brings up one of the interesting functions of the DSH2. You've got three different degrees of articulation. You have the swivel hitch itself, the gyrodyne, to turn left and to turn fully right. As you go through the field and one side of one tire falls into a dip, it can flex both this way and that way. And then you have when the clasp goes back down onto that retaining pin, it goes like this. If you fall into a dip or go over a hill, it will flex in that degree of articulation. So three different ways to adjust to different shaped fields and different contours and fields. Hooking back up, I just drop it back down. When I get all the way down, I feel the weight off the jack, come to the handle, pull it all the way back, take the pin, lock it in, hook up my PTO, my hydraulics, all the different auxiliaries, take the jack, store it sideways in the up position, and I'm ready to go to the field and cut. That simple. Of course, the thing that differentiates the TLs from any other machine on the market is the cutter bar. As Kuhn invented the cutter bar, we've had over 45 years to perfect the technology. And what you'll see on this machine is the OptiDisc cutter bar, our latest achievement. To open the hood, simply take the tool that's equipped with the machine, come down here, unhook the safety lock, pick it up, and it props open. Pull back the curtain, and we reveal the OptiDisc. What you'll notice and what you'll see on the OptiDisc is a couple interesting neat features. One is the fact that we have a low smooth profile cutter bar. That means when we drop this onto the ground, we're not going to have to angle it so much to get down if we want to get a nice close cut. At the same time, we can angle it back relatively easy, and we're relying more on the skid shoes instead of relying on the disc to take the brunt of any impact with a foreign object. As well, you'll notice the fact that the cutter bar itself is fully welded. The design of the cutter bar gives it extra strength because of the little indentations and loops inside there. You'll also notice that on each of the idler gears that transmit power through the cutter bar, it's bolted all the way through the gear case. This gives it extra rigidity, especially in tough, hard to deal with conditions. This will give a little bit more strength than what you'll see on other machines. Of course, the biggest thing that we see and that really differentiates us from everyone else in the market is the use of differential disc spacing. You might notice that as we see each one is 90 degrees from each other, our distance from this disc to this disc is different from this disc to that disc. Now, why that is if we spin it in the direction as it normally operates to bring crop in, you'll notice that the discs that are closer to each other counter-rotate away from each other. Now, why this is important is in cases of low short crop, traditional cutter bars have a tendency to blow air forward, which is knocks down that light crop because it doesn't have the stem behind it to hold it up. What we do to overcome this is we take those cases of counter-rotating discs and we space them closer together so we have more knife overlap. Whereas you see here, in the case that we're going the same direction as each other from this disc to this disc, we give a little bit more space. And what that allows is for more volume of crop to go through. Of course, one of the most useful things about the GMD TL as it's going through the field, of course, is float. On the TL, we do this pretty simply, and it all has to do with the geometry of the system. The head, as it goes through an uneven field, so you go up hills, go down little dips, going up, down and back and forth. What you'll actually see is we have our cylinder, and at the end of our cylinder, we have this slotted linkage. Of course, this is a cylinder that we pick the head up as we go into transport and drop it back down when we go to the field. Now, this slotted linkage down here, you can see there's a little bit out the bottom. It connects to this cross arm. This cross arm connects our header to the trailer frame itself. So as we go down into a dip, what will actually happen is this cross arm will drop down into this bottom part of this linkage. As you go back up, you can see it will rise. Now, it's also important to note, not just floating through the field, but encountering a, what we like to say, as an immovable object. So you hit a small tree stump or anything like that, not only do you want to be able to have shear protection like we talked about on our cutter bar, but you want to be able to rise, go over the obstacle, and then come back down. This goes back into the geometry of the arm itself. Allow me to demonstrate. As I pick up the head, like we're going through the field, you'll notice that this cross arm picks up and goes back and then drops back down. This allows us, if we're going through an object, going through like a stump or anything again, when we encounter it, the header will go back, go up at the same time, and then when you overcome it, drop back down. Of course, being able to follow the ground takes float. To accomplish float, we use springs on the GMD TL. You'll notice on this machine that we have springs mounted from our trailer frame to the head itself. To adjust float, and the reasons you would need to adjust float has a lot of different variances and a lot of different factors that evolve into it. The biggest thing is typically speed following ground contours. If you're in rougher, more hilly type of ground, you may need to put more weight on the header so it follows more closely with the ground, but not too much so you start to bulldoze. Whereas if you drive a little slower, and especially in smoother ground, you may need to take weight off of the head and put more on the spring. Now, to accomplish this is pretty straightforward. Over on the right-hand side of the trailer frame, we actually have a little toolbox. Inside this toolbox is a special tool that we use to adjust both the weight of the head, and also we use it to open up the hood where we can check the discs. Now, to do this, it's pretty simple. simply come back to the bolt head of the threaded rod. Turning to the right or clockwise direction will actually put more pressure on the spring, take weight off the head, so it'll make it lighter. If we need to make the head heavier to follow along the ground even more, again in rougher or faster speed conditions, we simply take it counterclockwise. You may notice on this 3550, so this is the 11 foot 6 inch cut, we only have one spring on the right hand side. Each model is a little bit different in terms of spring configurations, either quantity or how big the spring is. One thing that stays true on every trail disc mower, and also true on disc mower conditioners, is that the left hand side of the head will always be the heaviest. And the reason for this is we have the gearbox on that side that drives the cutter head. Of course, like every piece of machinery, operators want to make quick, simple adjustments, and the GMD TL is no exception. You'll notice back here on the trailer frame, both on the left and the right hand side, we have a lockout valve. What it does is locks out our lift cylinder for our header. What this is good for is during transport going down the road, you can hydraulically lock it out at this position, so you don't have any case of accidentally bumping the selective control valve and having the cutter bar drop down to the ground, which of course would be bad going down the road. You'll also notice on the left hand side we have a 1-point adjustment of our cut height. As you can see, to adjust it, all I have to do, take the lock out. If I turn it to the left, that raises the cutter head up to a little over 3 inches. So if you want to leave a little more stubble, you can take it all the way back. If you want to get a real close razor-like shave, simply take it all the way to the right as far as you want to go. Come in, lock it out, and you're set. From Broadhead, Wisconsin, we at Kuhn North America, thank you for watching.